Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. It's fielded at the 2. He's tackled at the 30-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And they make the stop around the 38-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Here's an opening. Makes it out to about the 46. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
He fights forward to about the 49. From their own 49-yard line, second down. And he's tackled at the 24-yard line.
Oh, that was one beauty of an option by that quarterback.
No question. There was no hesitation whatsoever. Once he saw that hole, he turned it upfield and left everybody in the dust.
They come out in a goal line set. He's taken down around the 25-yard line.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
From the 25-yard line, second down. Made at the 28-yard line. Tackle around the 24-yard line.
If something had been open downfield, they might have taken a shot. But all the defense gave them was the short yardage play.
It's fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Stanford could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and he splits the uprights.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
3-0, Stanford. He just drills this one. Bailey is lined up to kick this one off. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
Set. Cut.
Let's it fly. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds. That was a nice play.
You know, we talk about this every week, adjusting to the blitz. The quarterback and the receiver do an excellent job of recognizing the blitz and adjusting to the play. Good-looking pass.
Gets it out. He's met immediately. A 4-yard loss.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. Brought down around the 43-yard line. Woo!
hits him hard at the 43-yard line.
I like the call here. Looking for the big fella here on third down. They have a lot of faith in him as a receiver. Right there, he showed you why.
And down he goes at the 26. Around the 20-yard line. Turpin gained 6 yards with a short completion. Fires that quickly, incomplete. And here's another third down. Middle, got his back, and they got him for a loss, and they'll lose a yard there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. TCU can tie it up here with this kick. It's up, and the field goal is good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Nice run, and he's brought down. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Get him for a loss. To punt. And they push him out at the 29.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
The catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. It's second and 12. Ball on the 27. Scrambling around. And he's taken down right around the 30. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
And down he goes.
goes.
At the 43.
You talk about our meetings this week with the defensive coordinators, Kirk, and this is what they were hoping for, that they can control the line of scrimmage.
These players must have been listening pretty intently, because that's exactly what we've seen. These defenses have come out, they've controlled things early, trying to just set the tone. It's really going to be up to both of these offenses to try to make some adjustments and try to be able to come after them in some way.
He's tackled at the 42-yard line. So it's second and 12. Ball on their own 42. Tackled after a decent pickup. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they make the stop at the 34. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. He's scrambling, and he's sacked. And they get a nice defensive play.
Well, here's a play you don't see very often. That time they brought pressure from the corner position, and the line couldn't pick him up, and he was able to wrap the quarterback up for a sack. That's a good defensive call.
And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground, incomplete. The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Gets out to about the 21. Right around the 24-yard line. Room around the corner. Makes it out to about the 40. Field for a loss.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
Look at his scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. He's taken down at about the 35. Irwin is back deep to return the punt. He's taken down at the 39-yard line. don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Throws it out there. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
Mike 42, Mike 42.
Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. And he's tackled in the open field. Turpin is back awaiting the punt. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Short pass, middle of the field. Tackle made around the 35-yard line.
On the ball, on the ball. Hustle back, hustle back.
And he throws it away. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Going to bring up fourth down.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Nunez awaits the snap. Brought down at the 34-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. On play action, he'll scramble. Good open field tackle. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 45. They line up in the jumbo set. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Quick throw. Tackle at the 46. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45.
Four down, four down. Hey, Mike's 42, Mike's 42.
Nice run up the middle. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Excellent open field tackle. Tackles him hard at the 45. Complete. Brought down right around the 40.
On the ball, on the ball.
the 33-yard line. Makes it to the 21. So with that run, they pick up another first.
It's a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
From the 21-yard line, second down. He makes it to the 18-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. Falling back, incomplete. Just flung it out there, and it was short.
He got a little bit lazy here. There's no question he should be able to make that throw 9 out of 10 times. That was the one time he missed it.
From the 10-yard line, second down. And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. Open field. They'll bring him down around the 3-yard line. TCU is looking to go up by 3. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 1. Tackle at the 25-yard line. TCU's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. After a decent run up the gut. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Looking for his man, incomplete. He's on the run, and he's taken down right around the 34. Bailey is waiting for the snap. Booming kick. Gets to about the 34-yard line.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
He's tackled at the 35. TCU holds a field goal lead. He scrambles. And he's going to be sacked. Check three. quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Irwin awaiting the return. Looking for the corner. He's taken down at the 31. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
He's to the 40. And he's level at the 49.
First and 10. Ball on the 49. Up the middle, and he's stuffed. He throws it out to the flat. He goes out of bounds at the 47. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. TCU's got a three-point lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Let's go.
Turpin will be the return man. Oh, excellent punt. And he's tackled at the 20-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. TCU is up a field goal. He gets to about the 34-yard line. Slings it. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. A stop for a 6-yard loss on the play.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Gets hit out of bounds around the 38-yard line. And he's tackled right away. They come out on an empty backfield. Almost has the INT.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
From their own 45-yard line, second down. Dumps it complete over the middle, and they make the stop at the 50-yard line.
Nunez to punt.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
And they hit him in the backfield.
From their own 16-yard line, it's second down. Complete and taken down immediately.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. They bring him down in the backfield. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. TCU has a three-point lead. Throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 45. Throws to the tailback. Incomplete. Zips it to the back. He's pushed out of bounds at the 36. Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. At about the 23-yard line. Wears it out to the right to the halfback. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. They're packed in tight on the line. He fights forward to about the 33. Here's the run right. He's got nowhere to go. So it's another third down upcoming here. It's
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Tackle made
around the 34-yard line.
Bailey is the punter. Turpin takes it to 25. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
TCU is up by three. The junior makes the catch. Tackle at the 50. Incomplete.
Brad, this is a good job by this defense of getting after the quarterback, and until this offense finds a way to slow down that pressure, if I'm the defensive coordinator, I continue to dial up the blitz.
Trying to change the field position with his kick. He drops it. He got hit hard.
He was definitely peeking to see what kind of space he had to run. And that loss of focus is what cost him.
And in a tight game like this one, it's a mistake like that one that could really be the turning point in the game.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Nice run up the middle.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
He gets out to about the 21-yard line. On the ground with the tailback. Nice run to the outside.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down.
They line up in the jumbo set. Nice run there. Good running there.
Classic example of over-pursuing here by the defense.
After a nice run up the middle.
Second and six coming up here.
Ball on the 37. Quick strike to the back, no good.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. So the referee is going to take a look at several angles. Now remember, he's seeing the same thing we are, and he needs indisputable video evidence to overturn the call. So the call on the field will be reversed.
Scrambling, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
TCU holds a field goal lead. That's a great tackle at the 36-yard line.
To pick up the first down.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Fires quickly and it's picked off. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown, Stanford!
Job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
He makes the PAT. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 22.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
Brad, I know they turned the ball over the last time that they were out here, but it's important for these guys to remember they still have to lead here. Even though the momentum right now might be facing against them, they've got to be able to just settle down and find some confidence in being able to reestablish who they are.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Throws left. The running back's got it. He's tackled at the 21-yard line. Irwin, back to return it. Irwin fields it at the 41. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Stanford is up by four. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. From the 48-yard line, second down. Down at the 40-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 38. The running back goes for a short gain, but it's enough to get the first down.
Well, the defense did a pretty good job there and didn't give him much room. Unfortunately for them, it was just enough space to eke out 2 yards he needed for the first down.
And he's taken down at the 27. It's first and 10. Ball on the 27. tailback brought down for a loss. And down he goes at the 29. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. The Horned Frogs linebacker came out of the game with an injury earlier, but he's warming up on the sideline. Looks like he'll be back in this one. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
Well, that's one effective way to slow these guys down, getting a hand between the ball and the receiver.
Stanford holds a four-point lead. The kick is away. It's long enough. No good. He hooked it left. So the freshman kicker is unsuccessful this time. And our score, 10-6, Stanford.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Quick strike, and he drops it.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over it.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Offense lines up in a five-wide set. The defense anticipating pass here. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
Excellent pass defense. Got to be able to make a lightning quick reaction to bat the ball away like he did right there.
Nunez awaits the snap. And he can't hang on to the ball. He just couldn't pull that one in clean.
And Brad, that's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Stanford is up four. Out of bounds at about the 45. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. It's away, and it's a booming punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
Brad, everywhere we go when we travel all over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread, or the pistol, and hurry up tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
He steps out at the 23-yard line. Out of bounds at the 27-yard line. He's going to go for the home run. And they make the stop
around the 33-yard line.
Intercepted.
The linebacker here does a good job with his instincts and getting in the path of the receiver. Boy, what a great play.
First and 10. Ball on the 29. Stanford is up by four. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Had it intercepted. From their own 32-yard line, third down. And he tackles him hard at the 42.
Shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
2 minutes to go in the half. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Nice play, baby. Nice play.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. That's a 3-yard pickup.
The freshman took the quick pass, but the defense made a very nice read on the play. He didn't have anywhere to go.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Tackle made at the 26. Offense comes back out, looking to improve from their last effort.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's tackled around the 27-yard line. Out and he's going to get sacked. Boy, this defense really came to play today.
Well, they said before the game that they wanted to put a lot of pressure on this quarterback. They sure stuck to that plan.
Fires it quickly. He's taken down at the 46. So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. He guns it to the left. This one is incomplete, and that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
Looks middle, got his back. He's hit and taken down. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Runs with it, and he's got room. And he is drilled at the 29-yard line. Steps out of bounds around the 29-yard line. And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Check three, check three, check three.
Watch the out, watch the out.
Get out.
He lets it go. Nice play by the defense to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, instead of going for the interception, they did the safe thing, and that was just to tip it away.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Stanford holds a four-point lead. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line, first down. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. Defensive dominance through two quarters of play. We go to halftime. Stanford leads it 10-6. Very close game now as we start the second half.
He sends this one deep.
He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Stanford's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Around the 41-yard line.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From their own 41-yard line, it's second down. Zips it to the back. Tackle made at the 46-yard line. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. At about the 29-yard line.
On the ball, on the ball, on the ball, on the ball. That's it, that's it. Check three, check three, check three. Here we go.
to that quickly.
He's tackled
right around the 18-yard line. The 18-yard line.
He didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Caught out in the open. They'll bring him down at the 14.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
He was tackled immediately.
They'll line it up for the field goal.
Kicks up, and he's got it.
Well, not much in the way of offensive fireworks, but really, it's a good game nonetheless. Defenses have been bringing the wood the whole game. I think the team that can find a way to get a big play is probably going to be the team that's going to win.
TCU, the kick.
From the center.
He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
Stanford, up a point. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
Second down and 9 to go.
Ball on their own 30. Got him for a loss.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Nixon, back to return it.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick.
And he's tackled at the 30-yard line.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
And he's taken down around the 38-yard line.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Looked like it jumped early there.
They got across the line a bit too soon.
Give the quarterback some credit here for using his cadence to draw the defense off sides.
From midfield, first down. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
That was a great route by the receiver. It started out looking like a streak, but in reality, it was going to be a corner route the whole time. Nice job of beating the zone coverage and getting the first down.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop at the 28-yard line. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
And he hits him hard at the 24-yard line. He's tackled in the open field. Runs outside for a nice game. About 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Scrambling around. He's wrapped up for the sack. He makes it to the 6 yard line. It's fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. TCU can take the lead here with this field goal.
Kicks away.
And they tack on 3 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Broke away from one. And down he goes at the 25-yard line.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
He lost the ball. The offense scoops it. From their own 23-yard line. Second down. Nearly intercepted.
Ball seemed to float in the air forever, and it looked like the corner who got to it first. That's what happens sometimes when you give it too much air.
Bailey is waiting for the snap. Booming kick. Nixon takes it at the 32. He's taken down at the 42-yard line, and he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. Good job on their last drive, getting three. Let's see if they can get some more on this drive. TCU with a 2-point advantage. Quick strike and he drops it. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. A man and it falls to the ground. Rose, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
Nunez to punt. gets out to about the 32-yard line. This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. From their own 31-yard line, second down. To get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. Screen pass. He's got his halfback, and he shoved out of bounds right around the 30. Bailey awaits the snap. And this one is a beauty. He's to the 40. And he just got drilled.
Pretty good job by the return man there. We're about set to start things up again.
TCU is up two. He's under pressure. He's taken down
right around the 48-yard line.
He might have gained a yard on that scramble. And he's tackled around the 42-yard line. Stopped in his tracks. Looks to his receiver, first down. Tackle at the 32-yard line. Now he's scrambling. They bring the quarterback down. So it'll be second and 14 after the setback. Complete. He's got room. And he is drilled at the 27-yard line. TCU holds just a 2-point lead. Completes it across the middle. Nice play to set up first and goal. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Trying to go up by two scores. They line up for the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 9-play, 54-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
Sends it sailing downfield. Gets to about the 24-yard line.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
And he's tackled in the open field.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He fights forward to about the 36.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 36-yard line, second down. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked. Heavy pressure, slings it, and he's hit before it can go anywhere. So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. The call again. Tackled for a loss. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. This is the eighth play of this drive. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. He scrambled. Made at the 33-yard line.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
A conversion there could have really helped them, but it just wasn't to be. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out.
Tries to buy some time. That's a great tackle at the 47-yard line.
And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Airing it out long. Finds his receiver who's all alone. Touchdown, TCU. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. They'll go for two in this situation. They don't get it.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. And we'll be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. At the 30. Brought down at the 32.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Slings it out and it gets tipped. So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 32. Just throws this one away. Throws right away. Brought down at the 40. Nice play there to pick up the first down.
He did a great job of getting up in the air, ignoring the defenders, and coming down with the ball.
From the 40-yard line, first down. He's tackled at the 37-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. He's scrambling. It's a fumble. They fall on it.
What was most impressive is how he followed the play and he just didn't give up on it. It was that effort that allowed him to come away with the fumble.
Sure, that touchdown and their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
He's at the 40. And they make the stop
around the 32-yard line.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. And down he goes
around the 23-yard line.
He's on the run, and he's going to come up with a sack.
So that sack sets him back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. He's out of bounds at about the 19-yard line.
toss.
He came down with it. Touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. It's fielded at the 2. Tackle made at the 28. Stanford's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down. They're forced to punt. Their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they just got to take some chances at this point late in a game like this. Throw the ball down through it and hope that your receivers can make some plays.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. They line up in the jumbo set. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Bailey is waiting for the snap. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Fielded at the 19. Knocked out of bounds around the 30-yard line. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Complete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Out of bounds, right around the 40. One more quarter to play. The Horned Frogs are up by 22. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Irwin is back awaiting the punt. Looking for the corner. Tackle at the 37. Nice yardage on the run back. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball. Taken down around the 48-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 48.
Mike's 42. Mike's 42.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. Nice run up the middle. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Tackled after a decent pickup. To get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. from the 41-yard line. It's second down. And they get nice yardage on that run. Chucks it downfield. It's picked off, and it's the sophomore. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
First and 10, ball on the 26-yard line. And he snags that one. Tackle at about the 41. That gives him 100 yards in the game.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
Pushed out of bounds at about the 45.
Stay with your man. Mike Quinn.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Out of bounds, right around the 26-yard line.
Stop your body.
Mike Quinn. Check three.
And a quick throw, and he's tackled at the 16.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
Got a man open. Bad pass. This is the ninth play of this drive. The 10. Makes it out to about the 7. He might have a chance. And he tackles him hard at the 4. And almost had it intercepted. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 4. Tackle made at about the 3-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Going to try and scramble, and they got him. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
It's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The kick is up. And the field goal is good. TCU is ready to kick it away.
take it from the two. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Wide open. Oh, he dropped it. From their own 26-yard line. Second down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down at the 34-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. TCU looking to build on this commanding lead here. Wants to throw outside. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. Quickly, and it's almost intercepted. He steps out around the 45-yard line. That's a 3-yard pickup.
And a great job of not allowing this explosive freshman to do anything with the ball after the catch.
This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. He's under pressure. He's tackled around the 26-yard line. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series.
Bailey awaits the snap. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he's tackled at the 36. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. TCU is winning big. Now he tries to buy some time, and he's taken down at the 41.
from their own 41-yard line. Second down. Quick pass. And he is drilled at the 44. That's a great tackle at the 47-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. He goes out of bounds at about the 49. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. Initially, it was called a catch, but now we're going to find out for sure if he at least had 1 foot in and possession of the ball before he went out of bounds. So after the review, the verdict is that it was no catch.
They missed it on the field, but that was a bang-bang play. The important thing is they got the call right.
Just throws this one away. They'll line it up again on third down. TCU comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Throws this one out to the right. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Nunez is the punter. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. He's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack.
Mike 42.
Catches it, and that's all. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
Tries to scramble, but he's sacked. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He really got a hold of that one. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. TCU up by a bunch.
I like that they're completing these underneath routes, because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. That's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
He's knocked out of bounds at the 48. Manning gained 6 yards with a short completion. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Makes it out to about the 39.
In your face.
Hey, Mike 20.
Throws
incomplete, intended for his wideouts. From the 39-yard line, second down. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
He's on the run. They bring the quarterback down.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. They come out on an empty backfield.
Complete. It's the freshman. And they make the stop
at about the 37-yard line.
TCU up big right now in this one.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
Quick strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down at the 25-yard line.
It's second and five here.
Ball on their own 25.
Three down.
Hey, Mike's 42. Mike's 42.
Tailback with a catch and up for the first.
Second down and five. Ball on their own 40. Scrambling around. And down he goes.
At about the 47-yard line.
He's got it with room to run. He's taken down at the 42.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Three down. Mike 42.
Check. Now he's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Dives, and he's down.
To get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Hits him hard at the 40.
On the ball.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injury.
TCU comes to the line in complete control in this game.
Tackle around the 22-yard line. From their own 22-yard line. It's second down.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Incomplete. Tyler is back to receive. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 49-yard line.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
And they get the sack.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
A little over a minute in the game.
Steps up and he's sacked for a loss. And they get to him again.
Now, if they keep putting pressure on him like this, he might start to look to get rid of the ball quicker, which could very possibly lead to turnovers.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. With a quick throw.
Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end.
Check three.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home, and Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. He fights forward to about the 23. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. And he's tackled around the 25-yard line. Well, some backups got some playing time today, that's for sure. It's final. TCU, 35, Stanford, 10. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.